All right, hello. Today I'm recording another tutorial. This one's going to be about extracting files from an executable. And at first that might sound a little bit silly. Huh? How, files in an executable? How does that work? All it is a program, right? All it does is run code. Well, not quite. There's actually sort of some intricacies to the executable file format that mean that a lot of game developers can actually store their critical files inside the executable itself. It's sort of a neat little trick they do to keep people from just peeking around at everything they've got in the game. However, there are some fairly straightforward methods and some good software available that allow you to both take files out of an executable and put them back in. And I'm just going to walk through real quickly how I can make those work for me. Now, first off, we've got this wonderful program, PE Explorer. Now, this is sort of kind of like WinRAR, where it's just an infinite free trial that just never expires. So right here at the top, it says this is the 30-day evaluation version. Ignore that. It never actually calls your bluff. You can just keep using it forever. I downloaded this back in December, and it will still tell me I've got 1 day left to view it. For reference, I'm recording this video in February, almost March. So it's going to tell me after I load this file. By the way, we're going to be looking at the game Creepy Castle right now, which comes with nothing but this executable and some, like, random Steam files. And it will tell me that I have 1 day left, but I also had 1 day left yesterday and the day before that, so don't worry about it. If you do want to buy it, it's about $130, though. It's probably well worth the price. Now, after we've opened our executable file, we go to this button right here, Resource Viewer / Editor. And we see, oh boy, what are these? These are files. We have all kinds of files in here. And most of these are going to be pretty much useless. Like this is not going to be an important file for you. This is not going to be something you're going to be looking at. What you are going to want to see is this file called Cabinet. And right here, we see a bunch of text. And this itself are the actual files that are comprising the game. So we want to go to Cabinet. We want to go Save Resource As, and then somewhere on our desktop, no, not our Dropbox, our desktop, and Save. And this gives us this cabinet file, rcdatacabinet.cab. And the cabinet is basically just a very, very old file format for storing several files together. WinRAR works with it. I don't know if 7-zip would as well. And we can see this is the actual game directory inside. It contains our game, which we can do all sorts of stuff to. Nope, that's right, I already have a file with that name on that. Or a folder with that name already exists on my desktop, I should say. And now, let's say we've done, if we were to make a mod for this game and we want to package it back up so it's just like it was before. Well, there's a wonderful program that does just that, and it's not actually that wonderful. It's quite old, in fact, called Cab Pack. So this folder is very simple. It's just a way to make new cabinet files. I couldn't really find anything else that had this. So what you want to do is you want to go to the file that we're trying to pack up, or the folder, rather. Set that as our source. Our destination can be anything. We want to make sure that we have this one called Recurse Subdirectories on. Oh, and yeah, we do want to create the directory for our destination, but we want to make sure this button called Recurse Subdirectories is selected. What this means is that basically if you have folders inside the folder you're trying to pack up, it will go through those folders as well, the ones inside the main folder. If you have it off, it won't do that, and it will just only do the levels, or it will only do the files that are at the top level, which isn't very useful, I would argue. So if you run this, it's going to take a hot minute to complete. This is not going to be a super duper fast program. We'll just sit here and wait. It's not going to be too long. But what this is going to do is this is basically the only way I could find to get a cabinet out of a file folder. I couldn't find any other methods. I tried doing it with WinRAR. That didn't have support. I tried a few other programs. I couldn't really get any results. I think Wikipedia has a table that lists format compatibilities for several different programs, and I believe that's how I found this. But I'll link to all of this in the description. Okay, so now that we have that, we can go to cab pack, and it's created this folder here with a new cabinet file. Now we'll just rename that real quick, and we can use PE Explorer actually to add this new cabinet back into the old one. We right click, we go to Edit Resource, Open Source File, and then we go to our new cabinet file, and it will just do everything like that. And it will put the new files into the executable for you. And then you would go to File, Save File As, and that would be it. I'm not going to because I don't actually want to change anything here, but that's the basic process. So it's pretty straightforward. I just wanted to make this quick tutorial since it's not something that's very obvious on the surface, and I wanted to walk people through what my process was. I'm sure there are some other methods out there for doing this sort of thing, but this is what I came up with. Anyways, thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next tutorial.